Hello, hello, brothers and sisters. It's Teal here, Children of the Serpent, and welcome to another video. Today, we are going to just get a tad bit political. Just a heads up, we are getting into anarchy as well as spiritual anarchism and how the individual and the collective can work together. I know. Welcome to another insane video where we just talk about random occult shit. If you are brand new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. And as usual, if you have any comments, questions, concerns, or just want to drop in and say hi, go ahead. I respond as soon as I can. And I appreciate you guys taking your time to be with me today. So what is anarchy? It's a very misunderstood, complex political philosophy. A lot of people go back to the 90s punk where they're just like this rebellious, we do whatever we want, we're gonna hurt people kind of mindset, and that's where people really get stuck on that. They get stuck on that part when that's really not even accurate to what anarchy really represents. So anarchy ultimately is getting away from the government and the state. So they believe that this hierarchy that has been created is a delusional one. It's not necessary for humans to work together. And the fact that they have police officers and prisons to enforce these laws, that these very powerful people get to speak for pretty much all these other people, they don't feel it's adequate, like there's a better system out there. So there's aligned with a lot with socialism. So they go down into getting rid of the government and the state, and then just letting small communities of people, like-minded individuals come together and let them choose what rules they should have in that community, what they want to live by. And it really comes down to equality and working together, as no other human should tell another human how they should live their life. But that also means that the other human doesn't need to take away their rights either. So it really comes to respecting to one another. It's not about being selfish or hurting people or trying to do whatever you want. It doesn't come down to that, and it's not really necessarily chaos, because in this kind of chaotic philosophy, there's a lot of order within it. And that's really, from a political standpoint, anarchy is very misunderstood. There are four subtypes. There's various philosophers. You can look into it. I highly recommend it, especially if you, like me, you don't really support the government. Like, to me, it's divide, conquer. I don't identify as a Democrat nor Republican. I just see it as like a tool to use and manipulate people personally. So I'm not a fan of it. But if you want to get into kind of understanding more of the political side of it, go ahead, check it out. It's really interesting, and it's something that I personally, I'm probably going to identify, if anything, as an anarchist at this point in time, because I really resonated with what their vision is and what I agreed to, I think would bring a better world overall, but that's just my opinion, of course. Now, the main focus of this video is actually going to be spiritual anarchism. Now, the idea of the political standpoint of anarchy is actually found in other ancient belief systems. One of the more common ones that's associated with it is Taoism or Taoism. And that's because in Taoism that you shouldn't have like this outer influence from other people telling you, because it takes away from your balance that you can find within. Now, we recognize that we're all connected. We are connected by the time and space we're sharing right now. We are connected by our energy bodies. We are connected by this ultimate all consciousness. But we also understand there's individuals. Now, people think because there's this concept of collectivism versus the individual, there shouldn't be a versus in there. It shouldn't be black and white, because we know the world isn't black and white. Okay, so we don't need to be so extreme and have these two working against each other. So respecting each other as an individual is really important in spirituality, because when we're understanding and recognizing these energy bodies and this connection, we also understand there's not this sense of separation, but there also is. There's where we could, our consciousness, our thoughts. So instead of trying to group people into a set thing like, oh, this is the, these people are all gay and these people are straight, these people are Christian, these people are like this, or these people are this certain color. They don't see that. We shouldn't see that. It's understanding that each individual is a divine being, and it's seeing that person as that individual, not a group, not a title, not to try to fit them into it. But that also doesn't mean that as an individual, we shouldn't respect other people or try to work against what could help us as a collective. And then you got this collective mindset that has been used since, okay, well, I believe this is my morality and this is going to work the best. Why taking away from certain individuals at the same time? So we really do need to find balance. And as far as politics go, it's probably not going to happen. I think the political system, as far as I'm concerned, is probably not going to change anytime soon. And I'm sure not going to go join any protests to try to alter that. Not my thing. I'm here for my human experience, not to make the world a better place. I'm sorry if that sounds horrible, but it's the truth. I don't think I could change it even if I wanted to. But as far as spirituality goes, if we learn to understand the individual consciousness, it's also going to apply to the demonic divine. So y'all remember when I did the video about Satan, how I channeled him? He's like, hey, call me by my fucking name. Yeah. That's because we're respecting him as the individual consciousness. So as far as titles go, as far as language goes, we understand that to a point, these titles do not define everything that we maybe try to put into it. But also these names, these words, these descriptions have a lot of power behind it. It is our language. It's the way we are expressing. In itself, it is very magical. So when we're working with the demonic divine, even though there may be an all consciousness and they may be aspects of this all and we're all aspects of that, we still want to respect them as that individual. So you guys get into comparative mythology. Yes, awesome thing to do. It really is, because it's cool to kind of play around and see the similarities of various mythologies to all around the world. It's really a badass thing to do. But when you want to work with an aspect of the divine, you want to respect them as an individual, as you want to be respected as an individual. And that's where that comes into it. So we can work together, have that respect and understanding as the collective, but to understand and appreciate the ultimate all consciousness and this connection that we all have with one another, we have to find love within ourselves. We have to respect ourselves and then respect the individuals as individuals. And people are like, oh, okay, Tilo, what about the ego then? I thought you were all about death of the ego. Yes, one, death of the ego is really great for like spiritual ascension, but we all have a healthy amount of ego. That's just part of being human. There's no reason to necessarily press it, but it doesn't necessarily mean you should be controlled by it either. So again, it's a middle ground. You don't need to be all consuming, all this extreme, and then or be the complete opposite. You can just be in between, because life is in between. There isn't a day where it's completely perfect. Usually there's something that's good that happens in that day and another moment that kind of shitty, and then it goes that, because that's life and we're accepting as is. To want to constantly change or obsess or do this or try to fit people into small boxes is very neurotic. Let people express themselves, understand and respect that, and respect that within yourself. And your spiritual connections with one another, I promise you, will go deeper. That's because we all have something different. And just recognize, we all have the divine within us. And that's really where the spirituality and the collectivism can come together. And that's really where anarchy is teaching, is respecting each other as equals, as individuals. It's not about being selfish or imposing violence. In fact, our system's actually violent, because if you don't follow the rules, then it's pushed with violence. So I don't understand our systems at all. I don't understand politics. I hate it. But I really recommend looking into it and looking into anarchy, Taoism, and spiritual anarchism. There's a lot to it. If you guys, again, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, just drop it down below. Thank you so much for taking your time to watch this video with me. And y'all have an amazing day and darkest blessings.